Hey everyone, it's Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com, and today I'm going to show you my favorite new features inside of Adobe Photoshop CC 2017. Let's have a look at some things. We're going to choose File, New. And when you choose File, New, we get this new document workspace. And it shows you recent files here, save files when I can save my different templates, or we can go under the different category. You want to work in photo, print, web, etc. And notice what we've got now is we've got these templates that come from Adobe stock. And you'll see a lot of these templates are free, and you can just start using those right here inside of Photoshop. We're going to be using a template in a second. I actually think they're a lot of fun. The other thing we can do is notice we've got the different presets here. We can view all presets, and these are the basic presets you're going to want to work in, maybe a landscape, 8x10, etc. And you can see there's the settings right there. We can change the orientation from portrait to landscape. So if you want to do a portrait 8x10, we could do that. We can also click here and save it. And we just, you know, portrait 8x10, hit save preset, and notice under the saved, it'll be added on there. Of course, you can hit the little trash can to get rid of those. We've got, you know, different ones here, phone mockups and different things like that. Under mobile, we've got film and video, we've got some cool overlays and some different things like that that we can use. And also, you know, basic, you can see that 1080, etc. So you can just get in there and grab the preset you need very quickly. But let's have a look at some of the templates right now. I'm going to go under the saved because I downloaded one earlier. It's a magazine mockup. So just click on it. If you want to see what it does, click on the preview and you can get a better idea of what it looks like. And you can click back or close preview. All right, so why don't we just open this? I'm going to click on open. And there we go. We've got a basic template. I'm just going to hit Control 0 to make that fill the screen. And I notice I've got a left and a right page. And if you look on here, you can see there's a left page and a right page. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just click on the left page, double click on it to open it as a smart object. Now I'm going to do the same thing. Let me go over here and I'm going to open the right page, double click on that, and notice there they are as smart objects. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop my images in here. See, we've got smart objects here. I can double click on the smart object. And I can choose File Place. I'll show you how to do this. We're just going to choose File, Place Embedded. And right now I've got some of my aerial photographs, so why don't I just grab this one. And I'm just going to hold the Shift key and the Option key to constrain it from the center. Enter that, close it, and then click on Save. Notice it's been added. Now the other way we could add this is to simply click on one of these ones and then just choose File, Place Embedded. Let's grab a couple more. Let's grab, I don't know, this one. I'm just going to hit enter, choose File, Place Embedded. Now you can do this however you want to do it. Either directly, into the smart objects, or I'm just bringing it in here because it's a little quicker. All right, so we've grabbed those. So let's just hide those for now. And then what we want to do is maybe turn this one on here, and I'm going to drag it directly above that block. See that little block? This is your image here. Hit the Alt or the Option key. And that will just clip it in there using a clipping group. So I'm back to the move tool and notice I can just kind of move this around, reposition it. And then there's this last block here. I see it's right there. I control click on there, by the way, or command click. And I notice there's my photo. I'm going to put it directly above it. And then I'm going to hit the Alt or the Option key. And notice I can just kind of move that around to scale it. Control T, command T. And I'm just dragging from the corner while holding down the Shift key. Let's do the same thing over here. And I just want to scale it to fit. So, okay, looks cool. You could change this text if you wanted, make it say what you want. But let me just close that page, hit save. And if we go back to our design here, notice that that side is done. So let me go back to this one. And I'm just going to go into each one of these and do it this way. So we're opening that up. We're just going to choose File, Place Embedded. Let's find a long, tall one. This one will work. And what I'm using right now is my aerial photos from my drone. So if you want to check those out, I have those at PhotoshopCafe.com. You can see them all on there under my gallery. Let's just choose File, Place again. And also I have tutorials on YouTube on drone stuff, so it's kind of fun too, where I show you how to fly drones and capture these kind of images. So let's just put that one in there, close it out, hit save, and one to go, double click, and we're just going to place embedded. Let's go there so you can see the drone I'm flying with. Hit enter, save, boom, and then we've done that page. Now what we're going to do with that page is close it and hit save, and we'll update. And notice there's a little template there that we've been able to fill out with our own photographs to create this cool little magazine layout. So it's great for a little mock-up. Could be an ebook you're giving away or whatever. But there's a ton of different templates, so have a look at those. I think you're going to enjoy them. So every time you choose File New, you're going to see this new document with these kind of things in here. Now, a lot of people are going to find these really useful, particular new users. Now, for people who've been using Photoshop for years, it might feel like it's just kind of one thing that's getting in the way. So if you find that it's distracting, you can just turn it off. We just go under our preferences here. We just go into Photoshop, preferences, general. Then under here, we can use legacy new document interface. Click OK. Now when you choose File New, you just get the usual interface like you're always used to working with. So if you prefer that, that option's right there. So you can just turn it on and off right there in preferences. All right, let's have a look at something that's really quite amazing. Let's scroll down and find a picture. So here we go. If I double click here, you can see there's a girl with a book there. But what if I don't really like that one? It's kind of good, but it's not the perfect one I'm looking for. I can go into Adobe Stock and I can put in keywords and I can keep searching, or I can right click and choose Find Similar. And now by clicking on Find Similar, look at this, we can go right in there and directly within Photoshop, we can scroll down and we can see, you know, hey, here's some photographs it's looked at that are kind of similar. So, you know, he or she is sleeping with your book. Here's a different one where they're using a laptop. So this is going to show you some suggested images. You know, you'll see that it's based on context and it's also based on color. Because say, for example, we've got this. So if I right click and I decide to find similar on here, notice it starts to bring up that same kind of a color palette. And we can see we've got different types of photos based on that. So maybe we'll go here. Here's a nice ocean one. Find similar. And we get different ocean ones, but with a similar color palette. Another new feature we're going to look at here is the selector mask. Now, this was introduced in Photoshop CC 2015.5, but there's been some refinements to it. And one of them is speed. So if I'm going here and I want to select our girl on the floor, notice it's kind of a little bit faster than it used to be in the onion skin. And that's because we can change between high and low quality preview. So if we go for a high quality preview, it will show as it did before, but turning it off makes it faster. And of course, we can play around with our transparency. We can get an idea. So we hit the option key we don't want in there. And you can see we can go in and just do our thing. Now, let me just go over these edges. We want to kind of refine this. So let me grab this refine edge. And I'm just going to go around there and get better edges on this. Okay, so I'm not going to spend the whole time to do the cutout. Now, one of the other things that's been added is under the lasso, we now have a polygon lasso. Okay, so if we want to get these edges, we can actually do this now just by going around there. And let's just include these edges within our selection. And what that does is it just makes sure we have a nice crisp edge on our selection right there, which is great. And then just click OK to apply this to a layer mask. Right, let's double click on this and notice we've got a couple of people here doing some selfies. And what I want to do here is look at Face Aware Liquify. There's been some enhancements to it. So if we go under the filter Liquify. All right, so one of the fun things is if we go under the filter here and we go under the Liquify. If you're familiar with my 2016.5 video, I showed the Face Aware Liquify. In fact, I did a whole tutorial on it. So something that's been added in 2017 is we now can do the eyes independently. And this is great because really, let me click on there. We can do it on screen and we can change, you know, the sizes of these eyes independently by moving these sliders and doing different things. And notice that now it's just, you know, people tend to squint with one eye rather than the other, or in this case, where she's not looking directly front on and you want to change some things, you might want to do it slightly different for each eye so it looks a little bit more realistic. For example, we're tilting these eyes in. That looks about right. Notice it's 22 and 20. If we'd linked it, we can move these together, but notice it doesn't quite look right at the angle. So that's just kind of something that's nice that's added. Now, the other thing we can do too is the overlay. We can now click on there and that overlay disappears. You can actually just click on here and you can still work on the liquify. We can have some fun with that, but without those overlays getting in the way. So we can turn them back on and you can see, you know, showing the different things there. And once again, you know, we can change our nose. We can do all that kind of fun stuff. Don't forget, check out my other video on that. And we can just click OK. And you can see we can have fun with that. Now, this is not good for her. But if someone you don't like, you can certainly have some fun with that. So one of the things I always loved in Premiere Pro and I wished was in Photoshop was that way to get to a tool quickly by clicking on search. So now we have a global search within of Photoshop. So you can see here we can search different things there. So perhaps I'm looking for a tool like maybe we want vanishing point, say for example. We type that in and then click on it and boom, we can go into vanishing point. See that? So just very quickly, we can now find things. Or if you're not quite sure what you're looking for, and I just want to scale this maybe, change the size of it. Not really sure what I want to do, maybe resize. So we can click on the image size, and if we want to resize this image, we can do it without digging around in the menu. So you can see you can quickly find those things in search. So let's have a look at a couple of other things. One of them is type. I'm going to click on my type here. And I'm going to get ready to type some letters in here. That seems a little small. Let's make it a little bigger. But before I start typing, I want to add something kind of more fun. So why don't we go to the Properties panel? And yes, notice in the Properties panel, type is now there. And we can actually go here and do things like emojis. So we have SVG support now for text. And so I'm just going to grab on emoji one right there. And look at that, we can double click to apply these different emojis and we can use them right here inside of Photoshop. That's kind of fun. So one of the things I skipped on here is a properties panel. If you remember a while ago, the properties panel, there used to be things like the mask panel and things like that. And we would go in here and we'd create a mask and then we'd go into the mask panel and everything was consolidated into this properties panel. Well, once again, more things have gone into this properties panel, such as type and some different things, and you'll find that when you're working, this becomes your home base, so to speak, for a lot of different things. As you can see, basic options are available there. If you want the full panel, click on advanced and that full panel will open up. So a lot of different things, make sure you've got this properties panel open. So if I'm going for a minimalistic space, So I'm going for my minimalistic, and normally I work with layers, channels, and paths for a very minimalistic, but now I want to add my properties panel in there as well. And I'm just going to save this as a workspace, new workspace, and I'm going to call it min for minimal. And quite often I like this super minimal workspace for working on different things. So the other thing we can do too, of course, is we can change and go back to, you know, essentials or whatever. We can choose these different ones, but notice it's not doing anything. Hit reset essentials and boom, we're right back there. So I can quickly go backwards and forwards to the different workspaces like that. And then you can just resave them. So anyway, those are some of my favorite new features. Don't forget, hit the subscribe button because I create new tutorials every week. Become a subscriber, part of the Cafe Crew, and you'll get those new tutorials. And then you can stay up on Photoshop and Lightroom and different gadgets that I like to play with all the time. So don't forget, add a comment. Let me know what you think about this new release of Photoshop. Let's keep the conversation going. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.